You are shown four cards on a table. For each card, one side has a number and the other side is colored. Below the card is a rule. If a card has an even number on one side, it must be red on the other. One of these cards breaks this rule, and your job is to fish it out. You can turn over any card you want, but if you choose a card which doesn't need to be inverted, this will count as a fail. Which card slash cards must you turn over? Pause the video now to think about it. The correct answer is to turn over the 8 and the blue card. Remember, the rule was, if the card was even on one side, it must be red on the other. Since the rule is only about even numbers, we don't need to worry about cards with odd numbers. Now, a common mistake is to choose the red card. But if you turned over the red card and it had an odd number, this doesn't actually break the rule. The rule was only if a card was even, did it have to be red. So you need to check the 8 to make sure it's red, and you need to check the blue card to make sure there's not an even number on the other side. This might be a little confusing. But what's interesting about this riddle is that there are many variations, and some are much easier to get than others. For example, try this one. You are given 4 cards again, but this time, the 4 cards represent 4 people drinking at a party. One side has the person's age, and the other side has their drink. The rule is, if you're under 18, you are not allowed to drink alcohol. Which cards should you turn over? Pause now to think. The correct answer is 16 and vodka. Once again, we don't really care about the 41-year-old or the person drinking apple juice. All we care about is whether the 16-year-old is drinking alcohol and if the person holding vodka is older than 18. People tend to be much better at this version. The logic flows more naturally and the reasoning makes intuitive sense. And yet, these two riddles are identical in every way, except for some trivial distinction between number and color or age and alcohol. So, why is one version harder than the other? Well, before that, why does this result surprise us in the first place? And the reason is that we tend to believe in transfer. That is, we believe that once we learn something, a skill, a rule, or an insight, we can apply this new way of thinking to different areas of our life. For instance, once we learn how to add and subtract, we can apply this skill to grocery shopping and architecture. Likewise, riddle A and B both have the same logic, and I understand that logic. Clearly, I should be able to solve both with ease. And yet, this isn't happening. In reality, how we think about a problem heavily depends on the context and emotions surrounding it. So, the way we use logic in a maths classroom, for example, to solve a riddle, is very different from the way we use logic in a social setting, for example, to enforce drinking rules. This riddle really is just the tip of the problem. The real problem of transfer is in the area of educational psychology. How do we make sure that the knowledge taught in schools, colleges, and job training programs will transfer across contexts and into real-life situations? This will be the topic of my next video.